this woman goes, "Hey, Tom, you are in the emergency room and you overdosed." And they're like, "What did you take?" So I write, "Heroin." And they go, "Are you serious?" And I write, "JK."
Welcome to This Is Not Happening presents One Crazy Night. So this is what we do.
We're a bunch of comedians tell stories about a similar subject. So this is just One Crazy Night.
Give it up for my friend and yours, Mr. Tom Segura, everybody. Let him hear it.
Thanks. Ari Shaffir, everybody. Let him hear it. Ari Shaffir. All right. Let's go back to 1990. Seven, holy shit. And fuck, that time flies. And I'm a freshman in college. And Thanksgiving, remember Thanksgiving, everybody? That's the first time that you go usually back home. That's your first break in your freshman year. And it's a big deal because it's also like a mini class reunion, right? It's the first time you see everybody that you used to go to school with every day. You're back your first few months and everybody's recapping. And the big thing is the next day, the day after Thanksgiving, everybody gets together and parties their fucking balls off while acting like they're a new person, right? So I start off, I find the guy, one of the guys that didn't go to school, and he's like, "I'm the new drug supplier." And I'm like, "I remember you from math." And he asked me what I want, and I'm like, "What do you got?" And he goes, "I have ecstasy." And I go, "Yeah. Everyone says that's fun. Let's try it." And I start taking it. And I forgot to mention, before I went to college, senior year, I got really into a drug that was making its way, especially through the South, through Florida, called GHB. And I'm sure, I don't know if you know what it is. It's a gamma hydroxybutyric acid. Your body naturally produces it. Sometimes there's some places where they regulate it as an anesthetic, but basically when you get it, somebody made it in a bathtub, and that's the good stuff, all right? And they sell it to you, and they get it in a water bottle. They also call it the date rape drug. I didn't do that. I gave it to myself all the time. And it does have an amazing effect on sex. On masturbating, let's be honest, on masturbating. I really had some crazy masturbation seminars as a senior, and then I passed out, and I'm like, "Who jerked me off?" "Oh yeah, it was me." Okay. So, anyways, okay, so I get the ecstasy into my system, and then I take it. I'd never taken it, so as soon as I take it, I go like, "Hey man, fucking, I don't feel anything." He's like, "You just took it, man. Like, give it a minute, all right? All right." So I'm hanging out at this party. We're at a party, everyone's together, and then we're gonna go to a bar. And at the end of the house party on the way to the bar, I go, "Hey man, I don't feel anything." So he goes, "All right, when we get to the bar, come find me, and I have GHB." So I'm like, "Okay." So I find him, and he's like, "All right, let's go to the car." And that's always the big move when you go to the car, right? You're like, this is where dreams come true, in the car. A drug dealer's car is where it all lives. So I'm expecting what I know, which is a water bottle, and then a dose is the cap. So all you do is you pour the water into the cap and you drink it like that. It tastes like ocean water, like seawater, right? Salt water. And then it's immediate. GHB, if it's good stuff, it's like, we used to call it permigrin, because you just be like, ah, ah. And if someone's like, "Fuck you," you're like, "Ah." So I'm like, "All right, where is it?" And he goes, "It's right there." And he has a gallon jug, right? And I'm like, "Wow, that's not a water bottle." He's like, "Yeah, I haven't even put it into the water bottles yet. That's the full thing." And it's a full gallon. Now, if you think about a full gallon, you know that A, the cap is much different. It's flatter. You're not going to sample. And it's also heavier. So I don't know how to pour it. So he's like, "Just take a shot." And I'm like, "All right." So I put it up, and then I go in my mind, "Oh shit, I have like 9 shots in my mouth right now. So the options are, do I spit it back into the main jug, which I feel like he's gonna be like, not cool with that, you know? Being that he's a drug dealer and all. The other thing would be spit it out on the ground, and I don't wanna be rude, right? So I just go like, and I'm like, holy fucking shit. I have taken way too much GHB. Now, I'm leaving out the point that you're not supposed to mix GHB and alcohol. It is potentially fatal. You may have known this. If you didn't, it can be. At this point, I am on 13 or 14 drinks, right? Like, and it's liquor, like, you know, vodka drinks, and I'm just pounding them. I get the 9 shots into me, and then I walk back into the bar, and I'm like, what's up, everybody? Like, I'm fucking... They're like, where does all this personality come from? Ah, this is natural, man. So, and then I sat down. I remember sitting down, and the girlfriend came, and she sat on my lap, and then lights out. Like, I just don't remember anything. Like, I went to sleep. All I remember is that I wake up, and I'm looking at lights on a ceiling, right? I'm just like, oh, shit. Is this heaven? Or... And then I see a woman come into frame, right? Because I'm laying on my back. I can't talk. I can't move my arms. And this woman goes, hey, Tom, you are in the emergency room, and you overdosed on drugs, and now you're coming out of a coma. And I'm just like, like processing it. But the process literally was just eyes closed, like, oh, shit. And my only thought was like, I hope nobody knows. That's the only thing I'm thinking. I hope nobody knows. And then I open my eyes again, and my parents come into frame. And then I'm like, ah, everybody knows. And they look so just like, we thought you were a good kid. What the fuck? So I'd never been in trouble. They won't let your arm out because I pull out the tubes. I have a tube for breathing. I have another tube that's pumping liquid charcoal into my stomach because that makes the chemicals and the drugs like come together, and then you also can't digest it, so you vomit, which is what they want you to do. So as I'm like, I'm also like, I'm throwing up, right? So they give me a piece of paper and a pen that I can't really write normally because I'm strapped down, but I can kind of chicken scratch. And they're like, what did you take? Because they're trying to figure, they don't even know what I took. So I write, heroin. And they go, are you serious? And I write, JK. Right? They're not like, good one. They're like, what the fuck, are you joking? So then the kid in me, I'm looking at my parents and I'm like so worried about them. I write on the paper, I go, are you mad at me? And my parents, at that moment, my dad reads it and he goes, no, buddy, just disappointed. And I'm like, can you save that for when I'm breathing on my own? Like, so I'm in that emergency room. I get moved to critical, then ICU. In the ICU, a doctor comes in who I hadn't seen yet. And I'm later told, this is a doctor. They tell me, this is a doctor that saved your life. So I'm sitting there in the bed, and he comes in, and he goes, are you in a band? And I was like, what, man? What? And he goes, are you in a band? And I was like, no, I'm not in a fucking band. And he goes, well, you had enough in you to take down 2 drum players and a bass player, man. And I'm like, you now with the fucking jokes? Really? And I go, well, he goes, what did you take? And I go, I had, I don't know, I took a couple pills. I told him, honestly, I had some drinks. And I took some GHB, probably enough for, like, a lot of people. And he goes, what about the heroin? And I go, no, I was just joking. And he goes, no, you have heroin in your system. And I was like, really? And he was like, yeah, you have heroin, you have cocaine, you have PCP. He's like, you also have the same chemicals that are in, like, cleaners, like some of the, like, the Super Duty cleaners. And I'm like, what the fuck, man? And he goes, where'd you get your GHB from? And I go, one of my buddies from high school. He's like, oh, he's a good friend. He gave you some fucking WD-40 to put in your system. So I, you know, eventually get to breathe on my own and all this shit. And then he comes back, and they're like, you know, the doctor, the nurse tells me, the doctor that saved you wants to talk to you. And I'm like, all right. And I ask him, like, how did I survive? And he was like, honestly, because you're fat. Like, you're pretty fat. And I was like, what, man? And he goes, I mean, a smaller person would definitely, like, a 120-pound person would die halfway through this. This is just one of the only times where it's good to be fat right now. And that's, yeah. That's why I still haven't lost the weight, you guys.
No. I'm like, the best part is when he called you fat. Tom Segura, everybody. Keep it going for Tom Segura.
Hey, everybody. I just took a break from flying through space to tell you to click like over there so that we get more YouTube hits. And don't forget to subscribe so that next week when the story comes out, you'll get that as well. Well, there goes the celestial planet. Hi, planet.